Hey fellow Vault Dwellers, it's Angry Turtle, and I'm coming back with yet another video, this time taking one more look on Gauss Minigun. I did a review in the past, but unfortunately, this review is outdated. All the changes that Bethesda decided to implement in regards of damage and its calculation affected all weapons, including the Gauss Minigun. A lot changed, and let me tell what. But first, just quickly, if you are new, I will tell you how to get a Gauss Minigun. Then basically what you need to do, you need to finish the main quest line, new arrivals and side either with raiders at crater or settlers at foundation. It doesn't matter with which one, you will get it faster if you side with crater, but you can get it anyway even if you side with settlers. And this quest will finish when you unlock Vault 79. Then that's without the spoilers, just letting you know about the quest. And then you need to max out reputation with the crater, with the raiders, and then you can buy it inside from the robot Mortimer, and he will sell you all the plans for mods and for the gun. After that, you can craft it. And to craft it, you will find it under energy guns. And here it is, Gauss Minigun. It's quite a lot of resources, but most important, legendary modules. You will need two legendary modules and you will need science rank 1 perk to start crafting. And then you just need a good luck to craft something good. But now to the point of today's video, Gauss Minigun and its review. I have one on me. It's a bloodied with faster fire rate 2-star Gauss Minigun. And now let's take a look on the mods. I did a proper review in the past. Unfortunately, a lot changed. And starting from the barrel, as you can see, Penta barrel is still doing less damage than Tri barrel, but in this case, it's not nearly as much less as it used to be. Like Penta barrel at this moment can even offer a slight DPS advantage when it used to be just a worst possible barrel. Then Bethesda somehow recovered this barrel a little bit, although you will still use more ammo to achieve higher DPS. Therefore, I recommend to stick with tri-barrel anyway. You have more damage per shot, less shots, what means you'll use a little bit less ammo. And as you know, 2mm ammo is heavy and quite expensive. But it's worth to mention that pentabarrel, it's suddenly a good option, especially because you will get a little bit better accuracy with penta compared to tri-barrel, and unfortunately still, standard barrel offers twice the range. Then, yeah, slightly less DPS if you want range and accuracy, you go with standard barrel. What's the point that I don't really like, but it's in here. And now about the capacitor. As you know, Prime was always way to go. It was superior damage compared to anything else, but now, I was testing Tesla Coil Capacitor. As you can see, it's a trade-off. A little bit less ballistic damage, but some energy damage is added. And what I noticed from my observation, with Tesla Coil Capacitor, you are basically doing the same DPS as with the Prime Capacitor, as long as enemies can take explosive damage. What I mean by that, if you don't know how explosive damage works in this game, in order for enemy to take damage from explosive effect that is included on this weapon, all those bullets are explosive, even though it's not stated in here. Therefore, if you shoot enemy, the explosion caused by impact need to be big enough to hit the ground. Therefore, in the case of normal mobs, you aim torso or legs and you are getting this bonus. But if you shoot head, most likely you will not get any damage from the explosion. Therefore, this damage will be reduced, as this damage in here already includes explosion. Explosion damage is included, and at this moment I have equipped Demolition Expert, what means that damage will be lower by about 30% if I will aim for the head. Or in case of huge mobs like bosses, for example Colossus, if I will aim for the torso, I will lose 30% damage. If I will aim for the legs, I will get full damage stated in here. Then now, with this trade-off, what you should choose, and that's mainly what ammo you have on hand, as 2mm cartridges in ultra-sight version are kind of easier to craft. If you have flux, you will get much better yield, but in the same time, let me show you the ammo. I have the ammo on me. There is one downside. If we inspect 2mm ultra-sight cartridges, the weight is 0.005, and that's with batteries included perk under intelligence. And 2mm ammo, it's 0.003. Then it's lighter. It's actually half of the weight of ultra-sight. Then in this case scenario, you need to take into account that this ammo will weigh you down a little bit less than this ammo. You can see it much better if I unequip the batteries included. Now the ultra-sight is 004 and regular 2mm it's 002. Now you can see if you decided to use regular 2mm cartridges, you can carry twice as many. Then that's kind of a trade-off. Now what else you need to know, even though this weapon is doing ballistic damage, you craft it under energy weapon, and it actually is classified as energy weapon for the purpose of grounded mutation. That's why, as you can see, I don't have grounded mutation, as this will take away half of your damage. You cannot use grounded if you want to use Gauss minigun. Now, of course, we will shoot this weapon in a second, but first, just a quick comparison. As you can see, if we take a look at Gatling plasma, it's lower fire rate, but not by much, and slightly higher base damage. And Gauss minigun, it's slightly lower damage per hit and higher fire rate. From my calculation on Super Mutant Behemoth, the DPS difference was about 25%, like 25% higher DPS with Gauss minigun, but only if I was hitting torso and explosive damage was applied. Without explosive damage, actually, Gatling plasma is getting on the first place, and there's a reason for that. Let's go back to the workbench for a second and let's take a look on Gatling plasma. And now you can see what's happened. If I compare standard receiver with prime receiver in case of all the energy weapons doing energy damage, that's important, energy weapons doing energy damage, because Gauss minigun is energy weapon but doing ballistic damage, and therefore the prime receiver on Gauss minigun is not so great, and in here it offers you a solid damage boost from 171 to 212. I have no idea if it's intentional, but damage boost from the prime receiver on energy weapons, it's still multiplicative when everything else was changed to additive, including receivers on ballistic weapons, just not on the energy weapons. Now, of course, I'll be using this weapon in power armor to have a benefit of stabilized, and we go and shoot something now and compare a little bit with a Gatling plasma that offers you super cheap ammo and very similar damage, and in some situations better. Let's take for a spin Gauss minigun first, because this used to be a DPS king. It was insane before one wasteland. Now, it's good DPS. You will see, it's good DPS. But if we compare with other weapons in the moment, like a plasma, and there is a spin-up time, then even though I'm killing fast, but keep in mind I'm a bloodied build, and that is a great role of the Gauss minigun. Let's try to shoot in the head, can we? Yeah, you can see in the head, there is no explosion damage. You don't see the second damage. Like when I hit in the torso, you can see two damage numbers. The big one and the small one. The small one is the explosion. The big one is the main impact damage. And now, when I'm hitting in head, as I showed you before, and again, there is only big damage. The explosion damage is not a factor. We still kill faster because headshots are double damage in case of all the humanoids. Then we kill faster, but regardless, we are losing the explosion portion of the damage. Otherwise, this gun could be much better. If explosion damage will be applied for the headshots, it could be a boss killer, like a queen killer. Now, unfortunately, I cannot say so. Now for the comparison, Bloodied Gatling Plasma. It's the same effect, it's faster fire rate and Bloodied, just a different weapon. Full energy now. And oh, what I didn't show you before. The range is proper on this weapon. It's twice the range of the Gauss Minigun. Then that's one more thing that you should have in mind. The accuracy is slightly worse, but you can see in case of the headshots, I'm doing higher damage because I'm not losing anything on explosion because it's not explosive. Then in case of going for the headshots, yeah, I died. Okay, I'm back up. And what I was saying, in case of going for the headshots, this gun is actually a better option. What means that Scorch Beast Queen fights or air fights, I can use this Gatling Plasma instead, have cheaper ammo and better DPS. What's not really good in my opinion, comparing, taking into consideration how hard it is to get a Gauss minigun and what drawbacks you need to deal with when you decided to use it. I'm not quite in the nerd rage, but I'm still killing fast. There is slightly worse recoil on this gun, and accuracy is a little bit worse, but in the same time, better range, better headshots, slightly less DPS if I aim for torso, but nothing significant. It is less, but not a significant amount less. In the same time, if we compare it to like a 50 cal, it's probably still better option for everyday farming, as there is no spin-up time. You are not wasting time to spin up the gun when you need to spin up the minigun or plasma. Then that will be my review, updated review for the Gauss minigun. Let me know what you think. Do you agree with me that this gun should be buffed? As I take into consideration the cost of the ammo, the penalty to the range, and how hard it is to obtain this weapon, and I think it should be better than weapon that can be obtained from day one playing the game without going out of your way, spending thousands of gold bullion, grinding reputation for over a month, and then spending legendary modules to get your legendary variant. I'm interrupted. The one saving factor is awesome blue projectiles. But is it enough? Are awesome blue projectiles enough to redeem this gun? I was praising this gun before One Wasteland, as it was the best DPS, and even though it was expensive, it was a beast. Now it's just expensive and it's good. It's okay. Is it enough? That's my question. But you let me know, guys, what you think about it. That's my updated review of Gauss Minigun. And as always, thank you a lot for watching and see you guys in the next one.